Hello, students. I am Mr. Idowu Olajide Taufik, your English language teacher. In today's lesson, the topic is modal auxiliary verbs. Modal auxiliary verbs. Now, our objectives. At the end of the lesson, the student will be able to discuss the meaning or definition of auxiliary verb. The meaning or definition of auxiliary verb. Two, the student will be able to identify or define modal auxiliary verbs. The student will be able to identify or define modal auxiliary verbs. Three, the student will be able to explain the uses or functions of modal auxiliary verbs. The uses or functions of modal auxiliary verbs. And lastly, the student will be able to give good examples of modal auxiliary verbs and use them correctly to form sentences. Now, let us go for the definition of auxiliary verbs. The definition of auxiliary verbs. They are verbs which help other verbs. Precisely, auxiliary verbs help mean or lexical verbs. They are simply called helping verbs. That means auxiliary verbs are called helping verbs. There are two major types of auxiliary verbs, namely one, primary auxiliary verb, and two, modal auxiliary verb. Let me say them again. One, primary auxiliary verb, and two, modal auxiliary verb. Now, modal auxiliary verbs. They are used to express various moods and mental attitudes like hope, expectations, possibility, and futurity. They are used to express various moods and mental attitudes like hope, expectations, possibility, and futurity. Some of these modal auxiliary verbs are can, could, may, might, will, would, shall, should, must, ought, need, dare, etc. Let me say them again. Can, could, may, might, will, would, shall, should, must, ought, need, dare, etc. Now let us see the various examples of these auxiliary verbs. One, I shall go now. You need to do the assignment. She would apply for the post. I will write the note. He can type the letter. All these examples have modal auxiliary verbs such as shall, need, would, will, can. Now let us start with the functions of these various modal auxiliary verbs. Let's start with can. Can. It means ability to do something. It is used to, one, express ability. For example, I can teach English language. She can understand the poem. Two, to express capacity. For example, the governor can build more schools. He can work hard. Three, to express permission. For example, can I speak with the manager? Can I have a cup of coffee? Four, to express possibility. For example, he can come tomorrow. She can be angry with you. Could. It is used to, one, express past ability. To express past ability. For example, I could work longer if I tried harder. He could not attend the meeting because of the heavy rain. Two, to indicate indirect speech. E.g., she told me that she could help me. We said we could finish the work. Three, to make polite requests. For example, Could you post this letter for me tomorrow? Could you teach me English language? Students, I'm going to stop here to continue with the other types of modal auxiliary verbs in the next class. Students, welcome to the second part of today's lesson. Now let's continue our class with May, M-A-Y. It means uncertainty, not sure of. It is used to, one, express a wish. For example, may you live long. May God bless our governor. Two, to express purpose. To express purpose. For example, learn that you may teach others. Eat that you may live. Three, to express possibility. For example, the tutor general may visit our school tomorrow. Wazobia Max TV may air the program. Might, M-I-G-H-T. It is used to, one, indicate an indirect speech. For example, he said that he might marry her tomorrow. Amaka said she might become a teacher. Two, to make gentle reproach. For example, you might go there a little early. You might have told me earlier about it. Three, to express possibility. It might rain today. He might attend the meeting. Will, W-I-L-L. It means willingness. It is used to, one, express simple futurity. For example, the plane will take off in few seconds. They will come tomorrow. Two, to express determination, promise, threat, and willingness. For example, I will teach the students English language. This denotes determination or promise. I will sue her. It denotes threat. I will tell you the address. It denotes willingness. Three, to express characteristic behavior. For example, the student will listen to the news on Wazobia FM. They will boast of their wealth. World, W-O-U-L-D. It is used to, one, express indirect speech. For example, Janet told me that she would not like to marry him. Two, to express past habit. He would sit here and think about his childhood. Three, to express intention. For example, I wish the governor would visit the schools. Shall, S-H-A-L-L. It is used to, one, express futurity. For example, we shall visit Jos next week. We shall attend the meeting on Monday. Two, to express command, promise, threat, and determination. For example, you shall not smoke in the room. You shall get the goods. Now let's go for should. S-H-O-U-L-D. It is used to, one, express duty. To express duty. For example, the students should attend the classes regularly. Janet should bring the child. Two, to express obligation. For example, you should help the poor. Children should respect the elders. Three, to express probability or likelihood. For example, I should be able to complete the book in time. It should be in the school now. Student, I'm going to stop here and I'll continue the other aspects of modal auxiliary verbs in the next lesson. Thank you. Students, welcome to the last part of today's lesson. Must. M-U-S-T. It indicates order or command. It indicates order or command. It is used to, one, express obligation. For example, we must complain to the police. We must complain to the police. She must go with her brother. Two, to express duty. You must look after your old parents. We must use our right to vote properly. Three, to express necessity. For example, you must take the medicine daily. The student must work hard for the promotion. Four, to express strong determination. For example, I must teach her a lesson. I must become the governor. Oft, O-U-G-H-T. It means expected of. It is used to, one, express fitness. For example, you ought to be fluent in English. You ought to be a graduate for the post. Two, to express duty. For example, you ought to love your parents. Husbands ought to understand their wives. Three, to express necessity. For example, you ought to do your duties. We ought to be in the classroom. Now, student, let us look at this table. This table indicates the verb, the negative form, and the contraction form. The verb, the negative form, and the contraction form. That means, one, if I have can, the negative is cannot. The contraction is can't. Two, could, could not, couldn't. Will not, won't. Would not, wouldn't. May not, mayn't. Might not, mightn't. Shall not, shan't. Should not, shouldn't. Ought not, oughtn't. Need not, needn't. Dare not, daren't. These are the various modal verbs, their negative forms, and their contraction forms. Now, take this one as your class work. Fill the gaps with the following modal auxiliary verbs. That is, should, ought, would, will, may. Number one, you dash to pay your taxes. Two, he dash not pay unless he is compelled. Three, the governor dash make a pronouncement on the issue. Four, if you dash visit him, give him the letter. And five, they were afraid that he dash refused. Now, students, for further reading, you can consult the following books. One, Contemporary English Grammar by J.D. Moody. Two, A University Grammar of English by Randolph Quirk. You can also Google, or you can go to these two sites. The sites are www.grammarly.com. www.grammarly.com. And the next one is www.mbaenglish.com. www.mbaenglish.com. Students, this is the end of today's lesson. I hope you have been able to learn something very important. Thank you. God bless you.